Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'll be showing you guys how I made this basket cake, which is ideal for traditional marriages. I also have a video on how I made the fondant garden egg and kolanut I placed in the basket. So the link will be attached in the description box. So if you're interested to learn how to make it, you definitely want to keep on watching as we get right into the video. This is an 8-inch cake already covered in brown fondant. I trimmed and shaped the bottom part a little bit slanted to look like a basket. To achieve this basket cake, I'll be using my fondant already colored in brown color, and I'll also be using a tool, this green tool. It's called the fondant extruder. You can get this from any local cake store near you. And before I start working with my fondant, I first of all knead it very well so that it will be soft and pliable to work with. And I also add my Crisco, which is also called a shortening, so that my fondant can easily pipe out of the extruder. So after kneading the fondant properly, I will be rolling it into a sausage shape so that I can easily load it into the barrel. And when it hits the base of the extruder, cut out the excess and cover. I will be using the round tip because the extruder comes in different shapes. I'll be using the round shape. And after covering, I began to screw and wind the handle of the extruder to extrude the fondant, and it's as simple as that. After piping out the fondant, I use my smoothener to straighten it out. Actually, this is my first time of using the extruder, but the subsequent ones, I figured out a way to use it better, and I think I will still make a detailed video on how to use the extruder and different things you can achieve with it. So I already measured the height of the cake to know the particular place I will cut my piped fondant, and I'll be using a brush to apply water, which will act as a glue to the fondant. You can also use an edible glue for this. I place the fondant vertically to the cake and apply the little pressure so that it can get glued to the body of the cake. So after placing that, I will go ahead to unscrew the handle of the extruder so that I can be able to load in a fresh fondant. And this will be a repeated process I will be doing till I finish this basket cake. You can decide to pipe out the fondant till you get to a certain amount before placing them on the cake, but don't let them dry out. And you can also decide to place them on the cake immediately you pipe out. So whichever way works for you is okay. I also measured out the fondant I'll be placing horizontally, which is 2 inches. The one I placed vertically measured 5 inches, so the measurement depends on the size of your cake. I glued it with the help of water, and the design I want to do is to place one vertically and 2 horizontally, but just keep watching to understand me better. And the reason I measured them before starting is for all the horizontal ones to be the same height and all the vertical ones to be the same measurement, so I won't have one longer than the other. So here I eyeballed the space that can fit 2 of the horizontal fondant. I left those spaces and I went to the next one. So just keep watching, you understand me better. So after placing 2 pairs of horizontal ones, I went ahead to put a vertical one too. So after doing that, I went ahead to fill those horizontal spaces I left in the next line. And please don't mind all the patches you're seeing on the body of the cake. I let my daughter cover the cake so that she can learn to, and because I know I was going to use this basket weave to cover it up later on. So I hope you do understand the method I'm using here. I'm placing one vertically and 2 horizontally. I want to use this opportunity to appreciate my subscribers. You guys are amazing, and I want to say a very big thank you to those who have subscribed and those who are yet to subscribe. What are you still waiting for? click on the notification bell so that you can be notified each time I upload a video, and like and comment. That way I will know what you think about the video, and this will also encourage me to upload more interesting videos. And please share to your friends and your loved ones so that they can watch too. Okay, here I was using my fondant tool to press down the edges of the piped fondant. All the edges I pressed them down with my fondant tool. That way it will look more realistic, and it will also look as if the horizontal line is passing under the vertical line, just like a real basket. So I am pressing them down so it looks real. So I'll just let you guys watch and understand the method better. It's not as if when I just put the fondant, it glues and stays immediately. It looks that way because this video is forwarded. When I put the fondant, I give it a little time. I hold it in my hand till it sticks, and I try to adjust it here and there to stay in the position where I want it to stay. So here I am just putting one line of horizontal fondant because there is not enough space to add to. And if you take a closer look here, all the fondants are not touching the vertical fondant. So all I'm doing here is to use my fondant tool to push them forward so that they can meet and join the vertical fondant. So I just want to remind you guys that this is a repeated process of adding Crisco to my fondant, kneading and rolling it in a sausage shape, and piping it into the extruder and extruding the fondant, measuring it and placing on the cake. So keep watching. And this whole process actually took me like 4 hours.
After 4 long hours.
And I am done with the body of the cake, and here is the result. For the border, I piped 2 long strips. I'll be twisting them together like a rope to use for the top border. I cut out the edges with my fondant knife to make them smooth. With my paintbrush, I applied water and I placed the twisted fondant to form a border. And this just went halfway, so I repeated the process to complete its round. And this is the outcome. And this is a floral wire I twisted and bent it off the camera, and I'll be using it for the handle of the basket. And to avoid the floral wire having any contact with the cake, I will be wrapping, I'll be using the cling film to wrap around the part that I'll be inserting into the cake. So here I have already placed it into the cake, and using my paintbrush, I applied water at the base of the floral wire, and I piped out a long fondant, and I'm using it to wrap around the floral wire. So I'm going to be repeating this process till the whole floral wire is covered with the fondant. So here am I adjusting some parts of the handle, and we are done. Just for you guys to see how it looks like, I'll be placing the fondant, garden egg and kolanut, though I'll be removing it, and at the venue of the event I will be placing it with I'll be gluing it with water. So I'm just placing it for you guys to see. And the link of how to make this fondant garden egg and kolanut is already attached in the description box, and the link of how to make the fondant itself is equally attached in the description box, so do check it out. Wow, this looks so real, just like a real basket, a real kolanut, a real garden egg. Guys, what do you think? Let me know what you think about this tutorial in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you in my next video. Bye.